You can see this is the question from your NCERT book, has been asked in CBSE examination in 2012, 2013 and 2016. And the question is this, the question has been asked for 6 marks. So you need to be very careful in calculating its value. First of all, let's divide this integral into three integrals. First integral 1 to 4 mod of x minus 1 dx. Second integral 1 to 4 mod of x minus 2 dx. And the third is very clear to you, 1 to 4 mod of x minus 3 dx. In this first integral, lower limit is 1, upper limit is 4, and you can see critical value of this mod of x minus 1 means critical value of this mod of x minus 1 is x is equal to 1. And how do we find critical value? By putting this modulus function equal to 0. So on putting this mod of x minus 1 is equal to 0, or simply you can say x minus 1 is equal to 0, we find the critical value. And the critical value is x is equal to 1, which is lying here, not in between the limits, which you can realize here. Limits are from 1 to 4, and the critical value of this mod of x minus 2 is x is equal to 2, which is lying in between the limits x is equal to 2. And same here, you can experience lower limit is 1, upper limit is 4, means we need to calculate this integral in this interval from 1 to 4. And we can put this x minus 3 is equal to 0 to find its critical value. Critical value is 3, which is lying in between the limits. So the first integral should not be broken into two integrals, but the second and third, this will, we shall split in two integrals. First integral is from 1 to 4, will remain from 1 to 4. And what about the sign which we shall impose after removing this modulus? We need to put any value lying in between this interval 1 to 4 inside the function. So let's put any value lying in between. Let's put x is equal to 2 inside this, x is equal to 2 inside this modulus function. So it is 2 minus 1, which is positive. Whether you put x is equal to 2 or x is equal to 3 or x is equal to 3.1 or 1.1, whatsoever value lying between this interval, in all the cases it will be positive. So no need to put negative sign here because it is positive. But suppose if we had 1 minus x inside this modulus, suppose if we had 1 minus x inside this modulus function, then we need to put a negative sign to make it positive. Why? Because whenever we put any value lying between this interval, suppose x is equal to 3, we put 1 minus 3, which is minus 2. And now to make it positive, because output of the modulus function is non-negative. So in that case, we need to put negative, but in this case, we shall put positive sign, means will remain as it is, plus this second integral should be broken into two integrals. The first will be from 1 to 2, and the second will be from 2 to 4. From 1 to 2, what sign should be imposed before this x minus 2? Let's see. We shall put any value lying between, because we have broken it into two. Let's divide this interval into two intervals, and we put any value from this open interval lying between 1 and 2. Let's put 1.5. So if we put 1.5 here instead of x, we find 1.5 minus 2, which is minus 0.5. But to make it positive, we shall put a negative sign to make it positive. Means a negative sign should be imposed before this function. And suppose we take any value from this interval 2 to 4 and substitute this in this function, inside of this modulus function, let's say x is equal to 3 is that value. 3 minus 2 is positive 1. So no need to put any change over here. Just write it x minus 2 dx. And to evaluate this third, first we shall break this integral into two integrals as we did in second integral. So first integral will be from 1 to 3, and the second will be from 3 to 4. Because the critical value is lying between the interval 1 to 4, let's take any value from this portion, from this interval 1 to 3, and substitute in this function x minus 3. Let's put x is equal to 2 here. X is equal to 2. So I'm putting 2, x is equal to 2. 2 minus 3 is minus 1, which is negative. So to make it positive, minus sign should be imposed. Minus sign should be imposed. So the integral will be 1 to 3 minus x minus 3 dx. And the second integral, 3 to 4 mod of x minus 3 dx, we shall put any value x is equal to 3.4 from this interval in this, and we find that it remains positive, so it is plus x minus 3. Now it has become a very simple. We need to calculate it. So on calculating the first integral, it is x square by 2 minus x, lower limit 1, upper limit 4, plus into minus is minus. Integration of x is x square by 2 minus 2x, lower limit 1, upper limit 2, plus integral of this x square by 2 minus 2x, lower limit 2, upper limit 4, plus into minus minus, integration of this x square by 2 minus 3x, 1 to 3, and integral of this last is x square by 2 minus 3x, 3 to 4. Let's start calculating it. This will be 4 square by 2 minus 4 minus lower limit 1 square by 2 minus 1. Let's put this in a single bracket minus. Let's calculate this 2 square by 2 minus 2 into 2 minus lower limit 1 square by 2 minus 2 into 1 bracket close plus. Next integral, let's put x is equal to 4, upper limit in this 4 square by 2 minus 2 into 4 minus lower limit. So lower limit is x is equal to 2, 2 square by 2 minus 2 into 2. Again, bracket close. Now last two integrals I am writing here minus bracket. First we shall put x is equal to 3, so it becomes 3 square by 2 minus 3 into 3 bracket close minus lower limit 1 square by 2 minus 3 into 1 again bracket close. And to evaluate last integral, we shall put x is equal to 4, upper limit first 4 square by 2 minus 3 into 4 minus now lower limit 3 square by 2 minus 3 into 3 back minus this 1 square by 2 is half, half minus 1 is minus half, and due to this minus it becomes plus half minus this second integral. Second part, 2 can be cancelled. 2 minus 4 is minus 2. Just be careful while calculating because high risk is there in calculation. 1 by 2 minus 2 is minus 3 by 2, and due to this minus it becomes plus 3 by 2 plus 4 square by 2. 4 square by 2 is 16 by 2, and 16 by 2 is 8. 8 minus this 4 into 2, 8. So it becomes 0. So let's put 0 here minus this part. 2 can be cancelled. 2 minus 4 is minus 2, but due to this minus it becomes plus 2 bracket close. Next, this 3 square by 2 minus this 3 square by 2 is 9 by 2. 9 by 2 minus 9, 9 by 2 minus 9 is minus 9 by 2 minus this part 1 by 2 minus 3. 1 by 2 minus 3 is minus 5 by 2, and due to this minus it becomes plus 5 by 2. Again the bracket closed plus the last part 4 square by 2 is 16 by 2, 8 minus 4 3 is 12 is minus 4. So minus 4 minus 9 by 2, this 3 square by 2 is 9 by 2. 9 by 2 minus 9 is minus 9 by 2, but due to this minus it becomes plus. 4 plus 1 by 2 is 9 by 2 minus this minus 2 plus 3 by 2. Minus 2 plus 3 by 2 is minus 1 by This is simple, two, very easy, which we can write 2 into 2, 4 by 2. So the calculation will be easier. Minus 9 by 2 plus 5 by 2 is minus 4 by 2. Minus 4 by 2, and due to this minus, it becomes plus 4 by 2, which is 2. Or simply we can write 4 by 2. This integral, this last part, minus 4 plus 9 by 2, 2 for the 8, so it is 1 by 2. 2 for the 8 minus 8 plus 9 will be plus 1 by 2. All are having 2 in denominator. So just add their numerators directly. 9 plus 1, 10, plus 4, 14, plus 4, 18, plus 1, 19 by 2. So at the last, its value is 19 by 2. Its answer is 19.